They don't use the word Christmas because it's not politically correct. You go to department stores and they'll say Happy New Year and they'll say other things and it'll be red. They'll have it painted, but they don't say, well, guess what? We're saying Merry Christmas again.
That was President Trump vowing to put Christ back in Christmas. It is a promise that he made throughout the campaign, and he has been delivering, even putting the words Merry Christmas on the White House Christmas card. Can you imagine, for the first time in almost 10 years? So what does this movement towards keeping Christmas in the holiday season mean for the country? Here now, Tony Perkins, president of the Family Research Council. He met with the president just last week to offer counsel on religious issues. Tony, good to see you as always. Tell us about your meeting with the president on religious issues. What did you talk about?
Well, Martha, one of the things we were talking about was the move of the embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. But the president was really striking there in the Oval Office. He said, hey, Merry Christmas. You know, we can say Merry Christmas again. And as you said, the White House has made it very prominent in all of their displays, not only the decorations, but as you pointed out, the Christmas card that the White House sends out, which it's been absent in the last 8 years. You know, we've moved away from the political correct Happy Holidays to Merry Christmas. And I think, Martha, it's very, very important to understand that this is about a lot more than just, some assault on Santa Claus once a year. This is about an ongoing attack on religious freedom in the public square. And when the president made this a center point of his campaign as a candidate, the media kind of wondered, what's this all about? But it was a very clear message that the president understood that the ability to express your faith in the public square was under assault, yeah, and he was going to be pushing back on that.
Yeah, you know, I think people are relieved when you say Merry Christmas to them. I think they're happy to say it back to you.
Yes,
I think
absolutely.
That, you know, I think it's the sort of generification of faith that really people don't like. They don't like season's greetings and happy holidays. We have the card from years past, which said season's greetings from the White House. I don't think it means anything really to anyone. There was also a ceremony for Hanukkah, a menorah ceremony for Hanukkah that was at the White House as well. I think you want to recognize the richness of the different religions and the faiths that people practice in the country, not diminish them by making them something generic.
Right. 9 out of 10 of Americans, according to Pew Research, celebrate Christmas, and 2/3 of those recognize and believe the biblical story of Christmas, that Christ was born as a child in a manger in Bethlehem. He came to be the Savior of mankind. It was announced by angels. And so most Americans believe that. But you are right in terms of people feel relieved when you say Merry Christmas. I've tried this many stores. Every time I go someplace,
yeah, I
say Merry Christmas.
Like, oh, Merry Christmas. And people go, oh, yeah, Merry Christmas. Yeah. Merry Christmas to you, too.
Absolutely, because they're afraid. Most Americans are not looking for conflict, and we've had this cultural creation of conflict over Christmas because it is seen as a religious expression, because most Americans see it as a religious holiday. So the president coming to the forefront and saying, look, we're going to say Merry Christmas again, it is a signal to say, you know what, it's okay to express yourself on religious issues in our culture. Right. And his policies have followed that. We're going to the executive order on religious liberty. We're hearing from federal employees, career employees that are saying, you know what, we've never seen this before. They're calling us all in and saying, hey, this is Christmas time. Feel free to say Merry Christmas. Enjoy this time with your family and friends. And he said, this is a breath of fresh air. And this is how the president is using, quote unquote, the bully pulpit to restore freedom in the country again.
Yeah. I want to ask you about one other thing before you leave on the world scale, because there's so much persecution of Christians in the Middle East. It's a hard time for them at Christmas. You know, your thoughts on what we need to focus on with regard to that in 2018.
Well, I was just over in the Middle East a month ago, meeting with Christians in Egypt and in Jordan. And, you know, they're asking, pray for us. This is a remarkable time for them. In fact, today I was speaking with a Arab Christian pastor in Bethlehem. He is the pastor of First Baptist Church in Bethlehem. That's a pretty good deal, being the pastor of First Baptist in Bethlehem. But they're under intense pressure, a majority Arab Muslim culture, and they're saying, pray for us, pray that we can be light and truth in this culture, because we're seeing a lot of Muslims come to Christ, and they're saying, pray for us, that we'll be bold and courageous.
Tony Perkins, thank you very much, and Merry Christmas to you, sir. We'll see you soon.
Merry Christmas to you as well. Thank you.